that's the nature of the game. You can't do anything about it. I wouldn't say it's frustrating. It's just the laws of the game. The time it's supposed to finish, it has to finish on that time. But from my side, I mean, I wasn't thinking about it at all, because I know the time will come, and whenever it's supposed to happen, it'll happen. So I was just trying to be positive, think positive at that particular time. I know it can get frustrating at times, but there's nothing you can do about it. But I just went back happy. You know, 199 not out, I would take that any day. नहीं, जब भी मौका मिलता है तो हम कोशिश यही करते हैं कि वो अपॉर्चुनिटी को यूज़ करें अच्छी तरीके से, और जितना हो सकता है उतना आप परफॉर्म करने की कोशिश करते हैं। तो मेरे लिए भी यही था कि अपॉर्चुनिटी जब भी मिली है, अच्छा अपॉर्चुनिटी था ऊपर बैटिंग करने का, तो फुल यूज़ करना था, नहीं तो फिर काफ़ी कुछ होने वाला था। मुझे पता था आप लोग काफ़ी कुछ लिख लेते थे मेरे बारे में, तो इसीलिए शायद अभी अच्छे चीज़ लिखोगे। नहीं देखिए सर, वो मैं ज़्यादा उस रिकॉर्ड्स के बारे में सोचता नहीं, क्योंकि जब आप बैटिंग करते हो आपको पता नहीं कि क्या क्या होता है, कौन से रिकॉर्ड्स टूटते हैं, कौन से होने वाले होते हैं। बट ये सब रिकॉर्ड्स जो भी है ना, मैं जब खेलना छोड़ दूंगा ना तब देखूंगा, अभी तो अभी नहीं देखूंगा। Yeah, quite a few actually. When I was told, I mean, like I said before also in Vizag, after the first test match, I said it at the press conference that the communication between me and the team management was happening for a long time about me opening the batting. So mentally I was ready for it, because I knew it could come anytime. And then you know, speaking of this particular knock, obviously the most challenging, I would say. I haven't played much, you know, I played only 30 test matches. So yes, in terms of you know, what was thrown at me you know, in this particular test match, I would definitely say it was probably the most challenging one. थोड़ा जोर से सर, माइक है क्या? नहीं सुनाई नहीं दे रहा, इसीलिए। समझा, मतलब यार ऐसा नहीं समझा, मैंने सुना क्वेश्चन। बट जो भी जगह पे मैं पहला खेलता था, तभी भी कोशिश यही था कि मुझे अच्छा करना है, ऐसे नहीं कि ओपन करने के बाद ही अच्छा करना है। बट हाँ, मैं ओपन करना पसंद करता हूँ, लिमिटेड ओवर्स में कर रहा हूँ, तो टेस्ट मैच में ऑब्वियसली एक डिफरेंट चैलेंज होता है, जो कि मुझे पता है कि काफ़ी चैलेंजिंग होता है। और अभी तक मैंने 3 टेस्ट मैच ही खेला है एज अ ओपनर, सो इट इज़ लॉन्ग वे टू गो नाउ, सो आई एम नॉट रीडिंग टू मच इन टू you know, these 3 test matches a lot. Of course, I will take a lot of positives from it, but I'm not reading too much into it. See, opening the batting is a different challenge to batting at number 6 or 5 or 7 at times. So, you know, it's just about how you prepare yourself, what you talk to yourself in your mind about what you want to go out there and achieve. Because, you know, playing the first ball of the match and compared to playing after 30, 40 overs, it's a different ball game. There's nothing in particular that I've done in terms of technique, but of course I know the basics of the game. what you need to do as an opener in whichever format you bat, you know, because the new ball does something. Whatever conditions you play, we saw, you know, probably in Ranchi and Pune, it did quite a bit than the overseas conditions as well, like, for example, Australia or something else. So, you know, new ball, wherever you play, you have to have some sort of understanding about your game, understanding the basics of the game, rather, which ball you have to play at, which ball you have to leave, certain aspect of the game you need to be mindful of. So I was just trying to be mindful of that. I was allowing myself to take time rather than, you know, going after the bowler straight away, because with the new ball, of course, it's not a good idea. So yeah, but, you know, and as compared to number six, the ball is older, softer. You know, you got to play with little low backlift and things like that. So there are a lot of things, especially I'm talking about these Indian conditions. But of course, when you go outside, it's a different ball game, you know. So yeah, that is the challenge I'm awaiting. साला चाबू बैटिंग कर रहा है साला मत बोलो यार नहीं 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 ठीक है जू यार मतलब हमने देखा है अजिंक्य को इतने सालों से किस तरीके से उन्होंने अपना टेस्ट करियर आगे बढ़ाया है और टीम के लिए जब भी मुश्किल समय रहा है उन्होंने आकर टीम को बचाया है और ये कुछ एक दो इनिंग नहीं किया है उन्होंने काफ़ी इनिंग्स किया है तो और ये दिखाता है कि मेंटली कितने स्ट्रॉन्ग है वो और उनको कितना हंगर है ख़राब सिचुएशन में जाके बैटिंग करना और टीम को वहाँ से बाहर निकालना हमने इंडिया के बाहर भी देखा है इंडिया में भी देखा है तो अजिंक्य का जो टेस्ट करियर जो टेस्ट ग्राफ जो है वो एक एक स्टेप आगे ही जा रहा है और टीम के लिए ये इससे अच्छी चीज़ कुछ हो नहीं सकती क्योंकि मिडिल ऑर्डर अगर आपका स्ट्रॉन्ग है तो यू नो वॉट एवर सिचुएशन कम्स यू नो यू आर कॉन्फिडेंट दैट वन गाय विल पुट हिज हैंड अप एंड टेक द टीम फॉरवर्ड सो अजिंक्य ने उस समय जो पार्टनरशिप मेरे साथ की हम दोनों का जो पार्टनरशिप रहा है वो आई थिंक बड़ा क्रूशल था टीम के लिहाज से तो यस वो जो स्कोर हमने खड़ा किया है वो पार्टनरशिप जो बनाई हमने साथ में काफ़ी खेले तो अंडरस्टैंडिंग भी काफ़ी थी कौन से रन चुराने कौन से रन पे नहीं भाग कौन से उस पे नहीं भागना है तो ये सब काफ़ी कम्युनिकेशन हम दोनों के बीच जारी था और मैं काफ़ी खुश हूँ कि उन्होंने शतक बनाया वो काफ़ी चाहते थे कि एक बड़ा स्कोर खड़ा करे और अभी उन्होंने वो कर दिखाया और अगेन देर वॉज नो डाउटिंग हिज एबिलिटी एट एनी गिवन स्टेज बट अगेन यू नो कैरिंग फ्रॉम वेयर ही लेफ्ट इन वेस्ट इंडीज़ You know, he's in great form and it just augurs well for the team. Chabuk, Sala Chabuk khela.
Taking Sala's question forward and your answer, how do you approach this partnership? 39 for 3 you get together. The
yeah.
conversation must have been different then. Then in the second session, conversation must have changed. And today also, could you talk us through how you approach this?
Our plan was very simple. When we knew there was something in the pitch for the bowler, we just wanted to respect that spell. And we knew the time will come for us to, you know, get those runs in the second session. So we just wanted to play the first session quite cautiously and then see where we stand in the lunch. And then once we got out in the middle after lunch, it was Ajinkya who started taking that momentum, you know, and it was him... who actually got us the momentum for the team, you know. I think if I'm not wrong, he was batting on 40 or 43 balls just around the first drinks after lunch. So which means, you know, we capitalized on the loose balls. We got those singles as well. So the rotation of strike was happening every now and then, which is always good for a batsman. You know, when you keep changing strike, you know, it doesn't allow the bowler to just keep bowling there, because different batsmen, different style of play, the bowlers have to adjust their length as well. So I think we did that pretty well. So in particular, Ajinkya, he came out and he started playing shots, and you know, from there he never looked back. The partnership after that kept growing, and we knew that, you know, it's in India, you got to bat 5 sessions, you know, to win the test match. If you want to win the test match, you got to bat 5 sessions, get as many runs as possible. So that was the idea. So we wanted to bat long and see where we stand, the next day, which is today, during lunch. And then we can take the game forward, considering the weather after tea here doesn't look that great, you know. So we wanted to press, and we wanted to get as many runs as possible. And the weather, the bad light, it's going to keep happening every day here, I assume. So we wanted to get as many runs as possible quickly today, and then give South Africa to bat little and see what we can do. And we,